Hi friends, actually time is not sufficient to complete the previous video, so that's why I have continuing the same video. Yeah, this is first problem. Actually two sets have been given and we need to find out the relationship matrix and also sagittal diagram. So the relationship matrix is very simple. We need to write the elements of first set left side like this, 1, 2, and 3. And we need to write the elements of the second set on the top, A, B, C, like that. And the one shows the relationship between each thing. For example, in between 1 and B, the value is 1. That means there is a relationship between element 1 from first set and element B from the second set. Okay, that's the main theme. And next, the sagittal diagram is also very simple, and it is the relationship between the two sets. So one set is X and the elements are 1, 2, 3, and the second set is Y and the elements are A, B, C. And from which element to which element the relationship is there, and a line has been drawn. Okay, this is very simple thing. So as every element has a relationship with the other element, so definitely we need to draw all the lines. Now let us see the other problem. It's a practical problem where in many biological models the members of certain species can reproduce only with certain members of another species. Hence only some elements in two or more universes have a relationship in the Cartesian product. For example, if capital X is having two elements, 1 and 2, and for the capital Y, the elements are A and B. For the relationship, and if that is the case, and let's find out the relationship matrix and sagittal diagram for the relation. Capital R is equal to 1, A and 2, B. This is the relation. Okay, if, as we know, relation means it's a subset of Cartesian product of X and Y. So as here, for X there are two elements and for Y there are two elements. So obviously there are four elements in X cross Y relation, but here in this relation it has shown only two elements. So what about other two? The other two has, there is no relation. Okay, so let us see how we have to draw the relationship matrix and sagittal diagram for this problem. So this is the relationship diagram. Let us see, the first elements of the first set are 1 and 2. So let's write here left side 1 and 2, one beneath the other. And for the Y, A and B are there. So let's write A and B like this. And let us see the relationship. First, I want to see the relationship between 1 and A. Yes, there is a relationship between 1 and A. So, I will need to give the number 1 according to the characteristic function. Okay. And the relationship between 1 and B is, I didn't find any relation in this R. So, it will be 0. Similarly, I didn't find any relationship between 2 and A. So, definitely it will be 0. And I found the relationship between 2 and B, so the value will be 1. Okay, it's very simple relationship matrix. And then let us see the sagittal diagrams. For the sagittal diagram, we need to take the elements as dots. So first, for the set X, two dots has to be taken, and first dot name is 1, second dot name is 2. Similarly for Y, first dot name is A and second dot name is B, and I need to correlate them. So this is also very simple. See, there is a relationship between 1 and A, so I need to draw a line. And there is a relationship between 2 and B, so I need to draw a line. That's all. Very simple. So these are the things for a relational matrix and sagittal diagram. So up to this we have studied Cartesian product and crisp relations, and what are the relational matrix and sagittal diagram. And let us see the cardinalities thing. Cardinality of crisp relations. Suppose if n elements of the universe capital X, are related with the m elements in the universe capital Y. If this is the case, let us see what is cardinality. And the cardinality of capital X, as we know, the cardinality is number of elements. And it is represented as eta of X, mean capital X. And the cardinality of capital Y is eta of Y. Then the cardinality of the relation capital X between these two universes is eta of X cross Y is equal to eta X into eta Y. Okay, simple. Next, the cardinality of the power set describing this relationship is P of X cross Y is eta of P of X cross Y is equal to 2 power eta X into eta Y. And these things are exactly same as the classical sets. Okay. If you have any doubts, you can go back to that video and you can get the knowledge about them. Okay. These are very simple. So this is the video regarding regarding crisp relations and Cartesian product of crisp sets. Okay. If you like this video, please like it. And thank you so much for 1096 plus subscriptions till day. Please like this video and please share the video with your friends and family, maybe colleagues. If you haven't subscribed till date, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel. And please press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload the new video. And thank you so much.